Hi guys, my name is Vivek and in this video tutorial we are going to talk about the improvements that Oracle has done for the version 12c when it comes to partitioning. Guys, I have a quick request. If you have not subscribed to my channel already, please go ahead and do it now so that you get a notification as soon as I upload a new video. Now in today's tutorial we are going to discuss about four important topics, the first being mixing interval and reference partitioning. So in the version Oracle 11g, Oracle introduced interval partitioning and reference partitioning, but you were not allowed to mix and match interval and reference partitioning. That has been taken care of in Oracle 12c and I will show that in a moment. The other important thing is now you can go ahead and perform DDL operations on multiple partitions at the same time. That means you can go ahead and truncate multiple partitions, or you can go ahead and drop multiple partitions, which was not the case earlier in Oracle 11g. One of the most vital changes that Oracle has done in version 12c is global index maintenance. If you have seen my previous video tutorial on local versus globally partition index, you would have noticed that if I have created a globally partition index on a partition table, and if I go ahead and drop a partition from my table or truncate a partition from my table or merge a partition, the entire global index becomes unusable, and in order to reuse it, I will have to rebuild the entire index. So let's say I am dropping a partition. If I want to rebuild my index at the same time, though drop is a DDL operation, it actually gets turned into a DML operation because it has to rebuild that entire index again. So all the data from that index will be deleted and then it will be rebuilt, which actually proves to be a very costly process because it has to generate all those redo logs. And guys, trust me on this, especially when it comes to version Oracle 11g, lot of DBAs seriously refrain from creating global index just because of this, that their maintenance is such a tedious task, it can actually impact the performance of entire Oracle database. This has been taken care in Oracle 12c and I will show you how it has been taken care of. The other important thing that has changed is that now you can cascade operations from parent to child. That means you can go ahead and truncate your parent table, and if you have applied reference partitioning, you can truncate your child table on the basis of that, or if you have dropped your parent partition, you can cascade that to your child table as well. So here we are going to discuss these two things in details, the mixing of interval and reference partitioning. I'm just going to give you a quickly recap of what error we used to get if we used to do this in Oracle 11g and how that has been resolved. And then we are going to talk about global index maintenance. So let's go ahead and discuss mixing interval and reference partitioning. So here I have my parent table orders that is partitioned by range partitioning on the column order date, and I've created three partitions: data pertaining to 2015 and before, data in 2016 and data in 2017. Now as soon as I go ahead and execute this, Oracle is going to create three segments or three partitions on the disk, one for 2015 and before, one for 2016 and one for 2017. Now I have another table order items, and though it does not have the column order date, I can still go ahead and partition this table order items based on the column order date using reference partitioning. So the only constraint is that this particular order item table should have an explicit foreign key relationship with the parent table, and I will use this syntax partition by reference and I'll specify the foreign key relationship. So as soon as I go ahead and execute this, this child table order items, though it does not have the column order date, still it will go ahead and get three partitions created on the disk, one for 2015, one for 2016 and one for 2017. Now the challenge with Oracle 11g is, if my parent table is using interval partitioning and if I go ahead and try to implement reference partitioning on my child table, I'm going to get an error, ORA 14659, that partitioning method of the parent table is not supported. This has been taken care of in Oracle 12c. So if you try to mix and match interval and reference partitioning, if you are going to execute this particular code in Oracle 12c, it's not going to give you an error, it's going to execute successfully. So this is one of the major changes that has been done in Oracle 12c. The final important thing in Oracle 12c release is maintenance of global index table. So here I'm creating an interval partition table that I have partitioned on the column transaction date. It has three columns, ID, name, transactions. And now I'm going to go ahead and create a global partition index on the column ID. So I've created four partitions here for values less than 100, less than 200, less than 300, and then there is a final partition which covers all the values till the max value. Now this is the property of globally partitioned index, that a particular partition can contain keys from multiple partitions. For example, here this particular globally partitioned index contain keys for two partitions where data is less than 28th Feb and where data is less than 31st March. The same is the case for these two partitions as well. They contain keys for data less than 31st March and data less than 30th April. So as a part of my business requirement, I don't want to maintain old data. So if I go ahead and drop this particular partition, my entire global index will become invalid in Oracle 11g. And if I want to rebuild that index so that my queries still perform effectively and use that particular index, I will have to conduct an index maintenance, which actually is a DML operation. And imagine, guys, if you have billion rows in this particular index, that means your index is also going to be very huge. And since it's a DML operation, it has to generate all that undo and redo logs. And guys, trust me on this, DBS in version 11g are actually very skeptical of global index for the same reason, because if you go ahead and drop a partition, rebuilding these global index can actually hamper the performance of entire Oracle database. So they are very skeptical about it. In Oracle 12c, you still have to rebuild these index, but they actually don't become unusable right away. So if I go ahead and drop this partition in my Oracle 12c, my global index will not become unusable. It will still be valid, but it will have certain orphan entries. Now what I can do is, in Oracle 12c, Oracle has given me the advantage that I can rebuild my index at a later stage during my maintenance window. I still have to go through the generation of all those redo logs and undo logs, but now I will be doing that during my maintenance window, which is relatively safe period, and I can rebuild my index during that particular time. As I mentioned, in Oracle 11g, if I go ahead and truncate a partition or drop a partition, my global index actually becomes unusable. I can go ahead and update my global index using update global index. For example, here I am dropping a partition from my table transaction part IDX demo, and at the same time I'm updating my global index. Now update is a DML operations, so delete will happen on my index and it will generate all that undo and redo logs, which is going to take a lot of time. In 12c, you can postpone the index rebuild till your maintenance window. Your index will still remain valid, it just that it will contain some orphan entries which will be ignored if you go ahead and try to access those values, because they are not present in the underlying table anymore. So guys, these are some of the advancements that Oracle has done in its version 12c, which were not part of the version 11g. If you are using Oracle version 12c in your project, I'll recommend that you try them out so that you get a better hang of it. Thanks a lot, guys, for watching this particular video. If you have any questions, any doubts, just drop in a comment and I'll try to answer it as soon as possible. Thanks a lot for your time tonight, and I'll see you in the next one.